In the last video, we have seen the basics of charges, their properties, and the Coulomb's law in the form of scalar. Now we will discuss its vector form and the units of charges. So let's start with the unit of charge. As we know that the SI unit of charge is Coulomb, and one Coulomb can be defined as the charge which repel equal and similar charges placed at a distance of 1 meter from its in the vacuum or air with a force into 9 into 10 to the power 9 meter Newton. As we know that the equation of force, that is electrostatic force between two charges, equal to F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square. So if we place F is equal to 1 Newton, and we know that the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9, and charges are 1 Coulomb into 1 Coulomb, that is Coulomb square, and meter, that is 1 meter, then this force is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9. So 1 Coulomb can be defined as the charges with repel equal and similar charges placed at a distance of 1 meter, and it is in the vacuum or air with a force of 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton. The smaller units are 1 micro Coulomb, which is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 Coulomb, 1 nano Coulomb, that is 10 to the power minus 9 Coulomb, and 1 micro Coulomb, that is 10 to the power minus 12 Coulomb. In the CGS system, the unit of charge is ESU, that is electrostatic unit of charge, and 1 Coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to the power ESU. That means 1 Coulomb in the SI system, 1 Coulomb, and in the CGS system ESU, the relation between the SI system and the CGS system is 1 Coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 9 ESU. Now next, another unit is EMU, that is electromagnetic unit of charge. 1 EMU of charge is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 10 ESU, that is 10 Coulomb. One of the question arises here is how many electronic charges are in the 1 Coulomb of charge. So as we know that 1 Coulomb charge is equal to 1 Coulomb, and E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 Coulomb. Q is equal to 1 Coulomb. E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 Coulomb. As we know that the quantization of charge formula, that is Q is equal to Ne. Therefore, N is equal to Q by E. So, N is equal to 1 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power 19 Coulomb. If we calculate this value, we get 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. So 1 Coulomb of charge will contain 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. Now next we will move to Coulomb's law in the vector form. So let us consider two charges are there, Q1 and Q2, separated by a distance small r. The charge and the unit vectors are there. So let us consider two point charges Q1 and Q2 separated by a distance small r. Coulomb's force acting on Q1 due to the Q2 is given by F12. That means charge 2 on 1. Charge 2 on 1. So we write that as F12. Charge 2 jo hai Q1 pe kya charge laga raha hai? F12. Iska direction kya hoga? Is direction mein. So this is F12, which is K times Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Or is direction mein mera unit vector kaun sa hai? R21. So yahan pe hum log likhenge R21. Where R21 is the unit vector directed from Q2 to K1. And the value of K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Similarly, force acting on Q2 due to Q1, that means is pe ye charge lagayega, force ka direction idhar hoga, F21, aur unit vector ye hoga, so ye ho jayega. F21 is equal to K times Q1 Q2 divided by R square F12. This is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. So R cap 12 is the unit vector directed from Q1 to Q2. As we know that the both unit vectors are same, but their direction are opposite to each other. Therefore, vector R cap 12 is equal to minus of R21. So equation 2 can be written as F21 is equal to minus K Q1 Q2 divided by R square R21. That means is equation 2 ke mein R12 ke jagah pe hum log kya put kar denge? R minus R21 put kar diye, ye F21 ho gaya. To ye equation 1 aur equation 3 same ho gaya, bas dono ke beech mein ek minus sign ka difference ho gaya. So from equation 2 and 3 we have F12 is equal to minus of F21. So thus the force exerted by the two point charges are each other are equal and opposite. This is tarah ke force ko hum log bhi jante hain ki jab do bodies pe hamara charge equal and opposite lagta hai to isko hum log Newton's ke third law bhi kehte hain. So yahan se hum likh sakte hain ki Coulomb's law is in the accordance with the Newton's third law of motion. Now next we will extend this Coulomb's force in terms of position vectors. So let Q1 is placed in the xy plane at point A having position vector. Position vector kya hota hai? Kisi bhi charge ka distance origin se. Uska location ko ye denote karta hai. To Q1 jo hai vector A pe hai. Sorry, point A pe hai. Jiska position vector hai R1. Usi tarah se Q2 जो है पॉइंट B पे है, इसका पोजीशन वेक्टर है R2. Q1 और Q2 के बीच का डिस्टेंस है R. Q2 जो Q1 पे फोर्स लगा रहा है वो है F12 और Q1 जो Q2 पे फोर्स लगा रहा है वो है F21. दोनों फोर्स का ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन दिखाया गया है. सिमिलरली 2 जो 1 पे फोर्स लगा रहा है तो R वेक्टर का डायरेक्शन है R21. और इसके लिए हो जाएगा R12 R cap. So let us consider two point charges Q1 Q2 lying in the free space. Let R1 and R2 be the position vectors respectively. Coulomb's force acting on Q2 due to Q1 is given by this. F12 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by vector AB. ये दोनों के बीच का distance अभी हम लोग AB मान के चल रहे हैं. So mod of vector AB का square और R12. Now, according to triangle law of vector addition, triangle law of vector addition क्या कहता है कि अगर दो vectors दोनों sides को represent करते हैं vector A and vector B magnitude और direction में, तो उसका जो third side होगा वो उसके opposite order में इसको represent करेगा. तो in this case C is equal to A plus B. We have to see the direction of three vectors. If two vectors are in the same direction and the third vector in the opposite direction, then the third vector will be the sum of the addition of two vectors which are in the same order. So here we see that if this is this direction and this is this direction and AB is in this direction, then OA plus AB is equal to OB. So here we have written as OA plus AB is equal to OB and AB is equal to OB minus OA. The value of OB is equal to R2 and value of OA is equal to R1. So this is R2 minus R1. If we have written in the short form, it is vector R12. So therefore, F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by vector R12 in place of AB. We have written R12 square R12 cap. Now R12, but we know that R12 is equal to R2 minus R1. This is R2 minus R1 mod. So R2 minus R1 can be written as R2 minus R1 mod into R12 cap. Or R12 is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R2 minus R1 के मॉड को, या फिर किसी भी वेक्टर्स के यूनिट वेक्टर को हम लोग लिख सकते हैं a cap is equal to वेक्टर a डिवाइडेड बाय वेक्टर a का मॉडुलस. सेम चीज हम लोगों ने यहां पे लिखा. तो जहां जहां पे हमारा वैल्यू है f12 f21 वहां पे हम लोगों ने ये वैल्यू पुट कर दिया. सो पहले से हमारा ये स्क्वायर था, इसके जगह पे हम लोगों ने ये वैल्यू पुट कर दिया और इसके जगह पे हम लोगों ने ये वाला वैल्यू पुट किया. स्क्वायर और ये मिलके क्या हो गया, क्यूब. सो ये हो गया R2 माइनस R1 क्यूब, R2 माइनस R1. सिमिलरली कूलम्स फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन Q1 ड्यू टू Q2 इज इक्वल टू F12 1 बाय 4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट. डायरेक्शन हमारा चेंज हो जाएगा R1 माइनस R2, R1 माइनस R2 का कैप. सो ये हमारा कूलम्स लॉ इन टर्म्स ऑफ पोजिशन वैक्टर्स या डिस्क्रिप्टिव फॉर्म में हमारा यहाँ पे था. नेक्स्ट हम लोग कंपेयर करेंगे इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक और ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स में क्या डिफरेंस है. सिमिलर टेबल यहाँ बनाया है. इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स इट मे बी एन अट्रैक्टिव और रिपल्सिव फोर्स. ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इट इज एन ऑलवेज एन अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स, ये हमेशा अट्रैक्टिव होता है. लेकिन कूलम्स फोर्स या इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स अट्रैक्टिव एज वेल एज रिपल्सिव भी होता है, चार्जेस के नेचर पे डिपेंड करता है. इट इज ए लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स, इट इज ऑल्सो ए लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स. Is a two charges interaction force, it is the two body interaction force. यहाँ पे charges के बीच में interaction होता है, यहाँ पे bodies के बीच में interaction होता है, masses के बीच में. It varies inversely as the square of the distance between the interacting charges, that is Fe is equal to proportional to inversely proportional to 1 by R square, that is obvious inverse square law. It also varies inversely as the square of the distance between the interacting masses, so Fg is equal to proportional to 1 by R square. It is a central force, that is it acts along the line joining the center of two charges. It is also a central force. Electrostatic force is a very large as compared to the gravitational force. It is a weakest force in the nature. Gravitational force जो होता है सबसे weakest force होता है और electrostatic force जो होता है वो large होता है as compared to the gravitational force. तो यहाँ पे हमारा ये video complete हुआ. नेक्स्ट वीडियो में हम लोग इसके डिटेल्स में और आगे हम लोग देखेंगे कि कंटिन्यूअस चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन क्या होता है और हम लोग कैसे कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्जेस को आगे बढ़ते हुए हम लोग आगे बढ़ सकते हैं और कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स हम लोग उससे रिलेटेड सॉल्व कर सकते हैं.